Delay? No, they're going to say timeout. They did get the timeout in time. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. On second down, here's Tannehill. It's complete to Parker, left side. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Back now with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter begins with the Dolphins in possession of the football. And they're on the move here. They've got it 1st and 10. Inside the 30 now to the 28. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. They'll come out in the pistol. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing out 2nd down.
Michael Bennett's versatility, being able to play any position along the defensive front, allows him to make those types of plays. He finds good matchups and gets into the offensive backfield.
And there it works for a tackle for loss. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Making the stop that time, Bobby Wagner.
On a 2nd and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on 3rd down.
Tannehill. And a loss of 3 to bring up 4. On now the Miami field goal unit. This a 40-yard attempt from the left hash. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked.
Partner, I think they saw something there. I mean, they came from the right side deliberately, and you know there's always a designated guy who goes and blocks it. But it's the rest of his teammates that get him free.
Shift together here from the D-line. Throwing now, Wilson on 1st down. They set up the screen to Rawls. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down.
You know the key to a good screen pass is, don't you?
But you're going to tell me, good blocking?
Well, good blocking eventually. But first, it's good acting. You want to let the defenders go past you, leak out to whichever side or even in the middle where you want to set up the screen, and then you do your blocking. How about the read, though, by the defensive guys? They weren't fooled at all and actually ran with the lineman to where the play was and smothered.
Pressure comes, and Wilson's going to go down. Andre Branch in there to drop him with his first sack of 2016. Off the play fake. Here's Wilson. And he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his second of the game. Instead, fourth down.
A pretty rocky start in this game for the guy throwing the ball. Already has thrown one interception. Almost threw a second one right there. All he's doing right now is giving the defense a whole lot of confidence.
Yeah, this is away, and I don't think Landry will get a chance to return here. And the punt goes out of bounds. Where will they put it? They'll put it just inside the 45-yard line. The Dolphins' offense now working their way back onto the field. And they have to feel like they missed on an opportunity for points last time when they couldn't connect on that short field goal try.
And no doubt about it, because they were counting on those points. In today's NFL, let's face it, that's really a chip shot, right?
It's anything inside 40.
Yeah, they're counting on that going through the post. But we've seen it happen to teams before. Some of the best kickers in the world can miss kicks like that. Can they come back now and redeem themselves?
Now it's second and seven. Fake to Ajayi. It's Tannehill. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
7 yards remain now on third down. Now Tannehill. Deep drop, and caught by Cameron right side. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45.
And there's a completion to the tight end, and look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back to CenturyLink Field after this. Now a first down throw, Tannehill. And some room to roam now. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. Red zone opportunity. From the red zone now, Tannehill. And this is Parker, complete. That throw good for four. It's second down. 6 yards here to go for the offense on second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Got the hand caught up in the grill of the face mask. 15-yard penalty.
So tough for a defender. You're trying so hard to make a play. And the way that these offensive guys can move around, sometimes your hand gets into the wrong place.
They've made goal line offense a priority on the practice field this week. This is exactly the situation they've been prepping for. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Here's Tannehill now on second down. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. Nothing on the screen that time. Now it's third down. They couldn't get anything going there out on the right side in the flat of the swing pass.
And didn't we have a discussion with their staff about wanting to get the backs more involved in the passing game? Huge emphasis for this game, but obviously the defense had other plans and really made a nice play.
And he's able to get it down to the two. And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And Cundiff able to knock it through, and the lead moves to 10-0. So this time the protection holds up for him just fine, and he's able to bang it through.
I think their special teams coach got the point across. He gave him a pretty good earful after the block earlier, and this time there's no penetration, so they're able to pick up three.
Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Off the play fake to Rawls. Wilson. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now the Dolphins are going to take another timeout here. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And the offense now will try to regroup after the sack on second down. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And the dreaded third and long here for the offense. Rawls, the lone man in the backfield. A fake to Rawls. Now it's Wilson. He's going to wind up and air it out. It's caught inside the 25. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Tyler Lockett, as the first half is winding down. And the Seahawks have made this a one-score game. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. So just a three-point game now as they send this one away. Here's Jarvis Landry now on the return. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And out come the Dolphins now. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Now a play fake here on first down. On the left side, this is Stills. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An outcut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. The final shot here before the break. Tannehill sliding out of the pocket. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend as we send you cross-country to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando with our halftime report. Here's Larry Ridley. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be fielded at the six. He hurdles him.
Should get a gold medal for that one.
Out comes the Dolphins now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ballgame.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else. Well, that's the desired outcome coming out here in the second half, of being able to run the football and establish a little bit of pace and maybe even a bit of dominance at the line of scrimmage. And they want that to continue. Way too early to think about this being ball control time. But the way they're running it, you got to think they may want to continue that and see if they can go ahead and grind their opponents into submission.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to take it down to about the 35 here. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and two. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Ajayi. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. On first down, it's Tannehill. And this one's incomplete. It's one of those ones that is so hard to judge, but defensive holding there, that's what the referee saw. A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Get about 4 as he's brought down at the 24. Tackle made by Marcus Golden.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up 2nd and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front, because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
And the coach has decided to challenge this play. He has tossed down the red flag. Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination on whether to actually challenge the play or not. In this case, it didn't pay off for him.
And that's got to be so heartbreaking. You throw that flag, you probably feel really confident. And then all of a sudden, boom, you lose the challenge.
Yeah, when you take a look at it, you're throwing that flag because you believe you're going to be right. And when it comes back the other way, you have to regroup.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. That is caught at the 7. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets them up now 1st and goal. Simple slant route, and part of a really nice hard throw by the quarterback.
Nice timing between the quarterback and the receiver. They were perfectly in sync, and he put it right on him on the inside route.
This is Ajayi. It's a gain of 1 yard, and it'll set up 2nd and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
On second down, here's Tannehill. Looking for Landry, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, give up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. It's a loss of two, now third down.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Gotta credit them on that one because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them. Ran a screen, and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
And he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his second of the game. Instead, fourth down. Here's John Ryan now as he's on to punt for Seattle. Landry now on the return. It's a 40-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And the Dolphins will begin this drive in great field position, first and 10. And the Dolphins getting set to go here. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? Now Tannehill, and a hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. He was trying to get that one to Kenny Stills, and that takes us from second to third down. And the line to gain here is the 37 on third down. Throwing on third down, Tannehill rolling to his left. Now he's going to let it go deep. Looks for Parker, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now for the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. It's a big play there for Seattle. 56 yards. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. Offense needs something here on second down. It is second and long. They go play action now. Wilson, he's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. Call it a pickup of 7, and that'll bring up a third down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
Now Steven Hauschka, a perfect 6 of 6 from 50-plus last year. This officially a 55-yard attempt. That's on target, but it's no good. He had it online, but it came up just shy of the crossbar. And this score will stay right where it is. So it's an empty possession, and as a kicker, not the way you want to start your day's work.
And now each team's missed a field goal here so far, Brandon, so apparently neither guy is immune.
Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Not able to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. It'll be a pickup of 5, and that leaves him with 5 more. 3rd and 5 now. Back now in Seattle, Washington. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. So 3rd and medium here, 3rd and 5. Defense showing blitz. From the 50, it's Tannehill. He's going to let this one go deep. And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up 4th down. Here's Matt Darr now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. Taken in at the 11. They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and it'll be Seahawk football as they take over deep in their own territory. And Seattle now ready to march out of the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus-yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Again on 2nd and 10, it's Wilson. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. A gain of 4 on the play, and they're going to have a 3rd down.
I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. Well, they get the completed pass, but still have more to go here on 3rd down.
3 down, 3 down. Hey, check, check. 3 down, 3 down. 95, 95.
Watch out, watch out, watch out. Move. On 3rd down, Wilson, complete. Richardson has it. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29.
I love it. He ran a hitch route on 3rd and 6. And normally that's not deep enough to get your first down. I'd say he really ran a hitch plus to make sure he got the first down yardage. Really intelligent route running.
Yeah, because what do you say, hitches are normally 1 to 3?
Yeah, somewhere in the neighborhood. You just kind of come off the line of scrimmage and kind of show yourself to the quarterback and say, hey, here I am, present it. He went in and took it far enough downfield to make sure that they had enough yards to pick up the first down. Well, any caused incompletion is good for a defense. But when you add to it that you get a little hit on the quarterback, knock him to the ground, make him think a little bit, hopefully knock him off his game, especially in a game of this magnitude, this tight in the fourth quarter, got to feel pretty good as a defense.
It's caught outright by Graham. 4 yards on the pickup, and it'll be 3rd down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case the feet, did a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
Yeah, great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch.
Check, 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 check.
down, Wilson. They'll roll him out right. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
My high school coach, John Ford, used to say all the time, if you're in a bad situation, laddie, don't compound it with a bad decision as well. And I think that's what we just saw there. Harassed in the pocket, and he throws into double coverage anyway.
He called you laddie?
He called me laddie, and that was the nicest thing he called me.
Off the play fake to Rawls. Wilson. And left side here, it's Graham. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
To the offense lining up first and 10. Now Wilson on first down. Drops it underneath for Rawls. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
They'll throw on first down with Wilson. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. Second and 10 now, Wilson. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we ask a lot out of these guys. Block and catch the football, not easily done in today's NFL.
A nice gain of 21 yards in the red zone this time. Again, Wilson. This will be caught at about the 5. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It'll be a 2-yard gain, and that'll make it 2nd and goal. And they're going to speed things up here. There's Wilson to throw. And it's caught. It's a touchdown. And we'll have to check the flag, but I think this one's going to stand. Here's Hauschka for the extra point. And it's no good. Well, that could be a critical miss here in a one-score game in the 4th. The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field, and we are ready to rock. And this will be a touchback, so a first chance here in week 1 to see the ball be brought out with the new rule to the 25-yard line. Out comes the Dolphin offense now as they get set to take over here. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before and realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
To throw on second down is Tannehill. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Devontae Parker was the intended receiver. And it's 3rd and short. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains. The offense certainly looking to score some points, but they also need ball security here late as we get down to the final moments of this one.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. 3rd and 2 is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
And let's see what the defensive coordinator may have up his sleeve here to try to get this final last stand and win this football game. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
Well, we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, 2nd and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. A lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So the offense has it first and 10. Possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. Back to throw. And throw right side complete to Parker. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. It's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. There he goes, right side. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Short throw, pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide.
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Now Hausch could attack on the extra point. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly. Then they'll take it from there.
He'll come out throwing here on first down. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. They're going to hurry back to the line now. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Frank Clark in there to take him down. And the clock will roll. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And oh, look at that, a diving catch. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
Well, partner, when you ask anyone other than your QB to throw the ball, you must have a lot of confidence or you think you're really going to fake them.
And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And it would appear that the Seahawks are going to win this football game. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. First down, this is Rawls. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
Yeah. Wilson going to throw? Into a double team, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So now here come the Dolphins. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't, because now is not going to erase what's happened during the game. So after it's over, you're going to go to the film, find out where the game was really lost. But this is not a situation now where you're going to make up for anything.
We'll see what they do here. And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And some real confusion here. They won't even get to the line.
And this looks to probably be the final play. One receiver left, three to the right. And boy, again, they won't get this off in time. One final shot. They'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 15. And, partner, this first week, this first game that we get to call together, so special every year, week one. You had the flyover, the big American flag out there before the game, all the hoopla, just having football back, so special.
It is an opening day, opening game. There's just nothing like it because you really build to a crescendo. But the best part for us is that crescendo lasts for a while. Opening game here, an entire season. We get into the playoffs, to the Super Bowl. I was really excited. I could barely sleep last night. I can't imagine being a player.
So for the Seahawks, that'll be a happy locker room as they start the season 1-0. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Los Angeles Rams. Meanwhile, for the Dolphins, they go down to defeat here in the opener. And they'll look to get back in the winning column next week as they head to Foxborough to face off against the New England Patriots. So that'll do it. For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. It's a win for the Seahawks here as we say so long from Seattle.
Baby girl, you know you're looking mean. She said, how we gonna make it lot to get done, yeah. It's just something about a good old flood. Watching that red clay turn to mud. Sling it up, slap past the doors like a new paint job on a 4x4. Girl, you're gonna have a good old time. Can't let a little bit of rain change your mind. Let your hair down, kick off in boots. A woman's in your life, let yourself cut loose. Gonna get money from head to toe. Clean it all, living in a swimming hole. Listen, about to get dirty in the dirty south. I'm about to show you what it's all about. Don't worry, this rowdy crowd. We ain't scared, but still throwing down. We gonna tap, light that fire. We gonna crank that country. Pass that, pass it, get thirsty.
Baptized in muddy water, let me hear you say, let it rain, let it rain, let it rain, let it rain.
This is about to get dirty in the dirty south. About to show you what it's all about. Don't worry, it's a rowdy crowd. We ain't scared, we're still throwing down. We gonna tap, light that fire. We gonna crank that cuss. Pass that, pass it, get thirsty.
missed it.
Hello, my name is Kamau. I am from the clouds. I'm a human now, but I used to be your raindrop. Word up, I'm really good at putting words up. I make them levitate and circle with the birds. I don't need to force it, I let it occur. Whatever occurs, thank you. Feel like I was touched by an angel. Once again, a whole nother angle. I got a lot of holes in my ankle. I got a lot of love and a whole lot of ignorance. And that's a good thing if you want to relate. I'm trying to relate. It's come out like a power with an M. I get down like gravity, rap, rackety, rappers, and back rapidly follow the rabbit into the rabbit to being rabbit, unraveling, rattle riddles, and rivets into the sky. I'm a rebel, feeling rivety, rhythmically, and rhyme, vigorous, running right to the rhythm, whittle the side eye. I am the killer in the grasses. I am the kid in the corner with the glasses.
I am the specter, you should respect her.
I don't expect a special, ain't special. I don't expect her. I'm just really glad I could say something. That's a blessing. Ain't no stress affecting my presence. But sometimes the pressure keep pressing. Worst case, my impression impressed. That's the way to relate.
Killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been that they with this. Yeah, I've been killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been that they with this. Yeah, I've been killing that, yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that, flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist, flicking that, killing that, flicking that wrist. Let me tell you about the young man. Matter of fact, I'ma let Push tell that. Take it by the old man. Had a change of heart and then fell back. Old man lived a long life. Walked around with a long wig. Like Jesus, that Colombiana. That's me and models like. Look at the flick of that wrist. I'm feeling like Leonardo. Let me paint the picture. I might need a bottle. On the road to success, I can feel the throttle. That Michelangelo, hunters in the envelope. Type when I write. And that old man had a change of heart. Wish he knew it back from the start. Like, looked around, seen his wife on the. Military all over the whole compound. Soon as he seen it, I swear it, I mean it. My man was gone quicker than Vamanos. He in jail. Everyone falling like dominoes. Yeah, I've been killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the pain, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been that it with this. Yeah, I've been killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the pain, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been that it with this. Yeah, I've been killing that, yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that, flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist, flicking that, killing that, flicking that wrist.
Logic. Clockwise, counterclockwise, realest in the top five. Other four ain't rapping. I'm just rapping for the side. Yeah, that's coastlines, Panama for the boat rides. Worth billions, and we ain't even need Showtime. Just money counters and kitchenware, condo with a in there. We got rich in there. Been a trophy since Hawaiian Sophie. Curry over Kobe. We shooting. Splash Brothers with the add in soap. Good fellas to my Aureliotis. Let the sky fall, let it rain on you.
Yeah, I've been killing this. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been getting that with this. Yeah, I've been killing this. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been getting that with this. Yeah, I've been killing that, yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that, flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been killing that. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist, looking at, killing that, flicking that wrist.